Hi everyone, I'm Michael Brigham and welcome to Python for NMA second part. Just to recap, in this workshop we learn about basic Python techniques for the NMA tutorials, where we only learn a few things, but we learn to apply them well and often so that they become tools in our coding. In this part, we'll continue with the LIF neuron model that we introduced in part one, and then we will learn to structure code. So in part two, we will learn about other types of variables, other types of plots, and a little more in depth about NumPy. Histograms. Histograms are popular plots in statistics, where we have a random variable that we are measuring. So we assume that each sample comes from the same distribution, so from the same process that is generating the data, the samples. So let's say we have big N samples. And then we set some bins, number of bins, 16 bins, 32 bins, certain number of bins. And then we have a function, here mj, that counts the number of samples that fall within the range of each bin. So for example, when in the previous lecture, when we looked at ensemble statistics and we collected many realizations of our LIF neuron, we can, for example, take samples at a given time point. So here we're taking samples at 100 milliseconds and we are plotting an histogram, so the distribution of the values in each one of these bins. So here, this sample arrived at 100 milliseconds near minus 50 milliseconds, so it will count, it will go into this bin, and this bin gains one unit. Here in the middle, we have many more samples, of course, and this is why the histogram is much higher near these values here in the middle. Actually, for this type of figures, you could see where it's much darker. Just means that the realizations are superposing, and so an histogram that is taken here will be much higher with the sample count in the areas where it is darker. Okay, so it's coding time. Open your Colab notebook in exercise 1 and we'll practice histograms.